Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So we are discussing our lesson, that is sorting materials into groups. In that we are discussing the major point, that is properties of materials. So already in our some previous video we have discussed about the different properties of materials. So today we will continue with the same point, that is what properties of materials, and today in that we will discuss about the next property of the material, that is nothing but what state. Okay, so let's discuss about the next property of the material, that is state. So basically there are the different materials which are get distributed or which are get grouped into the solid, liquid and gas. Okay, so most of the materials are get grouped on the basis of their state, that is nothing but what solid, liquid and gas. Okay, so this solid, liquid and gas, these are the different states of the materials, and the different materials we can get into the solid, liquid and gases. But if this solid, liquid and gas is having the certain differences, so let's discuss about the difference between solid, liquid and gas. So first we'll discuss about the first one point is that shape. So we'll discuss the difference about solid, liquid and gas regarding the shape. So the solid is having fixed shape. Okay, the solid is having fixed shape while liquid doesn't have the fixed shape. Okay, the liquid doesn't have the fixed shape. Why? Because as you fill the liquid in any container, as you pour the liquid in any container, the liquid can take the shape of that particular container. Okay, and the next one is what? Gas. So the gases also don't have proper shape. Now let's discuss about the volume. So here we can say that what? Solid have definite shape, liquid do not have definite shape, and gas also not have definite shape. Like next one point we will discuss, that is what? Volume. So here we can say that the solid is having fixed volume. Okay, the solid is having fixed volume, liquid is also having fixed volume, but the gas doesn't have any fixed volume, or the gas doesn't have the proper volume. Next one point we will discuss, that is compressibility. Okay, compressibility means what? We can compress the different types of the state, or in the different state we can compress the certain materials. Okay, so we can say that in the solid state the compressibility is not possible. Okay, so we cannot compress the things into the solid. Okay, so see here, this is the duster. If I'll press it, okay, then also this duster will not change its shape. Why? Because the compressibility in the solid, it is what? Zero compressibility. We cannot compress the things into the solid state. Next one we'll discuss about the liquid. Okay, so in the liquid we can compress the things into the small extent. Okay, in the small amount we can compress the things into the liquid state. And the next one is what? Gas. In the gas state the compressibility is high. Okay, we can compress the gas in a more amount. We can say that the gases is having the highly compressibility. Okay, gases is having the highly compressibility. Now the next one we will discuss about the packing. Now packing means what? The arrangement of molecules. So we can say that in the solid the arrangement of molecules is how they are closely packed. How they are in the solid? The molecules are very closely packed. Okay, and that is the reason in the solid the compressibility is not there, or there is no compressibility possible in the solid, while in the liquid what happens? The molecules are loosely packed. Okay, means there is a somehow space between the molecules. Okay, so molecules are loosely packed in a liquid state, and that is the reason we can say that what? The compressibility is present in a liquid, but how? In a small contained, or the small amount of the compressibility is present in the liquid. And now we'll talk about the gas. So in the gas the molecules are very loosely packed. Okay, the molecules are very loosely packed, and that is the reason the gases is having high compressibility. The gases are having high compressibility. Why? Because see, the molecules are very loosely packed. There is so much space between the molecules, and it is the possible that we can compress these molecules. We can make these molecules to come together. Okay, so here we can say that if you are having the carbonated drink, or if you are having any cold drinks, so in that cold drinks the carbon dioxide gas is get mixed into the liquid at a high compressibility. At a high pressure the carbon dioxide gases get mixed into the liquid. Why? Because the gases is having high compressibility. Okay, so this is all about the different states of material, that is solid, liquid and gas, and also we have discussed about the differences between them. Now we'll move for the next property of the material, that is nothing but what? Floating and sinking. Okay, floating and sinking. So to discuss about the floating and sinking, we have to perform one activity. So let's start the activity. For that activity, what we need the one beaker which is full of water. Here I have taken some leaves, and also we need one coin. Okay, so now what I will do first, in this water first I will add this coin. Now in this water I will add this coin, and you have to observe what happened when I will add this coin in the water. What happened? The coin goes to the bottom of the beaker, or it gets settled at the bottom of the beaker. You can see here the coin is settled at the bottom of the beaker. Okay, now the next one we will do, that I'll add this leaf in the water. Okay, now you can see here what happened, that leaf doesn't goes at the bottom of the water, it is floating on the surface of the water. Okay, so from this activity, from this experiment, what we can see, that there are the certain materials, those who are well heavier than the water, and that is the reason they get sink into the water, while there are the certain materials which are lighter than the water, and that's why they are floating on the surface of the water. Okay, so some materials are heavier, and the materials which are heavier, they are getting sink in the water. Sink in the water means what? They get settled at the bottom of the water, and the materials, those who are lighter than water, they are floating on the water. Here you can see that the leaf is floating on the water. Okay, so some materials are sinking in the water and some materials are floating on water. So this experiment you can do with this different types of the objects. You can use the eraser, pencil, sharpener and different things, or the ball, all these things you can use, and you can come to know that whether this object is sinking or floating in the water. Okay, so this is the next property of the material. Now we'll move for the next property of the material, that is nothing but what? Transparency. Okay, that is what? Transparency. So let's discuss about the transparency. So now let's discuss about the next property of material, that is what? Transparency. So for that we will do one activity, or we can do one experiment. See, here I am having this glass beaker. In this glass beaker, behind this glass beaker, I will hold this marker. Can you observe this marker? See it properly. Can you see the blue color of the marker? So can you see that? Yes, you can see the blue color of the marker. Why? Because the glass is a transparent material. Okay, because the glass is a transparent material. Okay, so now what is mean by the transparent material? The material through which we can observe the objects properly, or we can see the objects clearly, that materials are called as what? Transparent materials. And that property is called as what? Transparency. That property of the material is called as what? Transparency. So here we can say that what? The glass is a transparent material, and the transparency is the property of this glass. Some other transparent material we can say that what? Clear water, air, also we can say that cellophane paper. All these are the
materials which are transparent. See, air, through the air we can see different objects. Okay, so it is means what? The air is also the clean, or air is also the transparent thing. Okay, so air is also the transparent medium. Next one we will discuss about the opaque. Now what is mean by opaque? See, here I am having this cardboard. This cardboard, now you can see this marker. Now I will hide this marker back of this cardboard. Can you see it? Can you see it? Yes, most probably you will not see this marker. Why? Because I have hide this marker behind the cardboard, and this cardboard is a opaque material. This cardboard is a opaque material. So what is mean by opaque material? The material through which we cannot see, the material through which we cannot see any object, that material is called as what? Opaque material. And the property of that material is called as what? Opaqueness. And the property of that material is called as opaqueness. Now we'll discuss about the next property, that is what? Translucent. Now translucent means what? There are the certain materials through which we can see partially. Okay, there are the certain materials through which we can see the different object partially, and that materials are called as what? Translucent material. That materials are called as translucent material, and that property is called, or the property of that material is called as what? Transluency. Okay, and the property is called as what? Transluency. So this is, these are the different types of the transparency. Transparent means what? We can see the objects clearly. Opaque, we cannot see the object. Translucent, we can see the object but partially, very blur look we can see it. Okay, we can say that blur look we can see in the translucent property. Okay, here the we can example take for the translucent, that is butter paper. Okay, for the butter paper we can see the partially, and that is the reason butter paper is the example of translucent material. And that is the reason, now you can get to know why the shopkeepers are keeping the different eating items into the glass jar, because it helps the customer to see the different objects clearly, and that is the reason the shopkeepers are using the jar which is made up of transparent material like a glass. But here I can say that there are the certain plastic bottles, that also transparent. Okay, so these are the three types of the transparency. So here we have completed our lesson number 4, that is what? Sorting materials into group. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We will meet in the next video. This is the time to tell you goodbye, and for today, thank you.